Hello, in this video I'll explain how to implement a kinematic control to track trajectories with a mobile robot with wheels in Copelia Sim VREP software. So the aim of this presentation is to implement PV proportional velocity or PD proportional derivative kinematic control using a Pioneer 3DX robot. This is a robot that is included in Copelia Sim inside the mobile folder of the model browser. So search for it, and actually in the real robot, this robot includes encoders to measure the speed of the wheels and also 16 ultrasound sensors, and even some models include a laser rangefinder. So in this presentation, I will assume that the robot position is known, and therefore we can get access to that position and also the robot orientation. So, in order to start, we need to create from a blank scene, a new scene. We need to create a path, like the one I'm showing here. Basically following the indications I explained in previous videos about how to configure paths. Okay, but in summary, the path must be closed, flat, and also pointing, the x-axis must be pointing up with the automatic orientation. So please check the properties of the path, so make sure that you have the proper setting. So before you start programming, the robot comes, or the model of the robot comes with a default script, so we don't want to use that script, so you need to delete it. And then we have to create our own child non-threaded script to implement your own code, okay? So in addition, to establish the wheel speeds, you must access to the robot motorized joints and call the function set joint target velocity. And this is something we explained on previous videos several times. So basically, you need to get the handles and then you need to set the target velocities, modifying these two zeros you see here with the corresponding computed values for each of the wheels. So, in trajectory tracking problems, we have to track or follow a point, and this point will be actually a dummy object that we need to add to our scene, and we need to make it child of the path, as you can see there. Okay, and check or make sure that you have the follow parent path property checked. Okay, and also you can even increase the object size, so if you can see it better or bigger. Okay, so also there's a parameter which is called the offset, and this is a distance with respect to the initial trajectory point, could be positive or negative, and this is a parameter that you must adjust depending on how you have created your own path, and basically depends where your path starts. Okay, and make sure that you just simply put it just in front of the robot with a reasonable distance, not too far, not too close, so whenever you start it doesn't need to speed up too much or just to move backwards. Okay, so yeah, okay, so also just you can implement the code I'm suggesting here to get the handle of the path, to set a specific velocity or nominal velocity to that path, that will be the speed of the point moving on the trajectory, and also to get the handle of this dummy that we will need for later use. Indeed, we can also implement the function as I show here, the get trajectory point function. The goal here is to access to the position and orientation and also the speed of the trajectory point. So the position and orientation can be obtained with respect to any reference system. In this case, by introducing the number -1, we're indicating that the position and orientation are with respect to the world reference system. Okay. On the other hand, the speed, the API that Copelia Sim provides to obtain the speed of an object, it's always with respect to the world reference system, so we don't need to introduce this second argument. Okay, so the function I'm providing here returns two output arguments, each of them with three coordinates or three values. The first output argument includes the position and orientation of the trajectory point, while the second argument returns the velocities of those coordinates. Okay? So, in particular, for the orientation, you have to see here that we are using a weird expression to compute the orientation. This is, or the reason behind that is because the reference system of the point attached to the path is different from the one in the wall. And we need to, or I suggest you to implement the code as I'm providing here. Anyway, you can try to check if everything is correct by printing the values of this trajectory on the console and make sure that you're getting the correct values. So, as I said before, we will assume that we have access to the true robot position, also known as ground truth position. Here we are somehow cheating, okay? So this is because we don't actually know the actual position of the robot without using additional sensors such as sonar or laser rangefinder. In another video, I will explain how to compute that position from the robot's odometry, okay? But from now on, we just simply need to create a dummy that we will make a child of the robot object. And we will need to place it just right in the middle of the wheel's axle. Okay, you can see here in the figure. Okay, so the idea is that it has to be aligned with the wheels right in the middle, and the z axis has to point upwards, and the z x axis has to point forward. Okay. So to access to the robot position, we will need to implement this simple code. On the one hand, you need to access or to get the handle of the object that I previously that we previously created. In this case, is the robot pose, and also to create or to initialize a variable called pose that will provide us with the actual or the initial robot pose. Okay, so indeed, I put here also a function to how to get access to that pose, and it's rather quite simple. We have to get access to the object position and orientation of this dummy, and this function returns one single argument but with three numbers which correspond to the x, y and orientation of the robot. Okay. With all these previous steps, we are ready to implement a PV kinematic control. The maths related with this control has been explained in a previous video, so I recommend you to look carefully to it, that video, to fully understand the meaning of each of the variables. In particular, B and R are constructive parameters, parameters that depend on the robot. In particular, they are the separation of the wheels with respect to the center and the radius of the wheels. Okay. So try to obtain these values from the robot geometry itself. Okay, the parameter E is a distance that you can or we must set, and it represents the distance over we want to perform the control. This is what we know as the off-center point. And the bigger the distance is, the softer will be your control. But on the contrary, it will have lower correction capability. Okay, so the gain KP in this case is the gain of the proportional controller, and we are providing with this controller a feed forward of the reference of the off-center point velocity. Okay, the rest of the variables that you can see here are related with the configuration of the robot, describing the x, y, and orientation of coordinates in this case. Also, we have the reference trajectory point, either for positions and orientations, but also for velocities, as you can see here. I suggest you to try to implement this kinematic control, and optionally, you can also try to implement a PD controller too. Well, in this video, I have given all the necessary instructions and indications to be able to implement the kinematic control to track trajectories. In the following video, I will show how you or how this type of algorithm works with the Copelio Sim simulator. Thank you very much.